Good morning everyone, and welcome to another episode of my vlog. So today I have a special episode. I'm going to a weekender called Detonation Dance, which is in Manchester. So as you can see, my room is currently in a mess. I've got clothes everywhere. That's because I'm trying to prepare for this, and very excited but also a bit nervous because it's my first time going, and I will hopefully be meeting my friends there. Well, let's see what we have planned today.
Detonation Dance is an annual West Coast Swing event held in Manchester. It's organized by Eastern Swing and it goes on from Thursday to Sunday. The event is going to be filled with lots of activities like workshops, competitions and social dancing.
We didn't head out to the pre-party on Thursday as we were tired and wanted to meet up with the rest of the dance group from London. So we started our journey on day 2, Friday.
As you can see, both Izzy and Sophia were taking their sweet time while Kieran was rushing to the event.
So we got to the hotel and we were going to register here. I got this awesome wristband. The venue was pretty empty when we arrived, but it didn't take long for it to be filled up. As you can see, there is the DJ booth.
The first workshop was conducted by Phil and Flo from Canada, Montreal.
Back with a little kind of circle.
So you can circle it up, or you can bring it down.
And six and one,
back,
two.
Just
next, we had a switch workshop where you switch your role from a leader to a follower and vice versa in the middle of a pattern. Echo and Naomi did a workshop next. They taught us on how to spice up our dance. After a short break where I could munch on my snacks, Ben and Cameo did a workshop. To be honest, I don't remember what it was, but it was a bit funny.
They already know what to do. They know that they're rotating. So now I get to worry about the exit. One hand, other hand. Don't get scared. And just go, stop. Yeah.
Kevin and Aggie from Evolve Swing in Milton Keynes, London, did the next workshop. And before we headed for lunch, me and Kieran did a line dancing workshop. I think all I needed was a cowboy hat, jeans, and I think it would have been perfect. Then we had lunch and the first round of competitions were about to begin.
Take a small circle, be at the top.
After a few hours of watching the dance, I decided to take a closer look at that mental wellness table from earlier. As the night progressed, we had more dancers coming in from all over UK. The t-shirt demonstrations were next, and it started with the
Hosts
organizers, Lee and Fabian Eastman. My favorite dance of the teacher demonstrations was this dance by Steve and Kate. I just really liked the music and how they moved in sync to it. Ben and Cameo gave a very energetic performance. And then we had the award ceremony, and with that, day two was done.
Counting down from first place to first place, we have in first place Miguel Menez and Julia.
We decided to say our goodbyes and head back to our Airbnb.
We're here at Detonation Dance, Aesop Hotel.
Ever tried banana bread? Well, we were all about to get our first taste of it.
It kind of is, but we're all curious. We wonder how this experiment's going to turn out.
Because it's going to go all nice and gooey.
Like you mush up some bananas on some toast?
And speaking of melted bananas, the next day we had Steve and Kate doing a workshop on melting.
We just practiced melting. Relaxing. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3.
Next, Ben and Cameo did a workshop on musicality.
To incorporate the music. We have 5 different elements of texture. We can change our rhythm. We can change our height. We can change our angle. We can change our speed. And we can change how our body moves through it. Right? The vision of the day.
And then we had the competitions picking up again. We had Masters Division, which was for people above a certain age group. And we also had the novice, intermediate, and advanced competitions.
Here we can see we had some social dancing in the middle of the competitions. If you all know me, for lunch, obviously, I got a beautiful cheesecake while my friends got all these healthy
Thank you
lunches.
Very much.
You're on this vlog forever.
Yeah. Beautiful.
That's a really nice cheesecake.
Yeah. check this out, even the baby started judging everyone's dance. Damn, Edwin looks so cool in that shirt. Next we had a party game, so this was called Nations Battle. This is where my friend Kieran injured himself and couldn't compete.
What happens after detonation?
Back at the venue, things were getting really hot as Liz and Jordan, my favorite couple, were competing against each other.
And then we had the finals. Nadia got selected for the for her first finals, and she looked a bit nervous here, but I think she did a great job. And finally we have my favorite dance of the night, featuring my dance teacher Colleen Mann. And words can't do this dance justice, you just have to check it out for yourself. With that, day 3 is done and we move on to the final day, day 4, on Sunday. I got to the venue early and as you can see, there is no one here, it's empty. It's a wasteland because everyone danced till 5 a.m. on Saturday. Next, we had a couple more workshops which were a continuation of the workshops on Friday and Saturday. And as usual, Echo and Naomi did an amazing workshop on styling. I wish I would have recorded the entire workshop.
Oh, that's what you say. Okay.
Finally, we get to my dance competition. I was competing for the newcomer Jack and Jill competition, and I got Jihan as my follower. So I'm really happy that I got her because she is one of the best followers. And with that, my dance was done. I'll tell you the results of the dance later in this video. So I met up with Edwin and he gave us some valuable advice on how the triple step in West Coast Swing differs for blues compared to dancing to pop music. And with that, my first weekend was done. I had so much fun, and if anything, I'm completely committed to going down this rabbit hole of dancing, and I can't wait to compete in future events. As for my results, I finished in last place. I got 0 from all the judges, but I am, even though it's quite sad, I'm happy that I competed, and I quite expected to place low because this is my first competition after 6 months of dancing, and now I'm excited and I can't wait to analyze my dance, see where I went wrong, do more private classes, go for my regular classes, and hopefully one day become a champion. Thank you all for checking out my vlog and hope to see you next time.